Today, I offer you an exciting journey as I hop on Morocco's high-speed train, Al-BORAQ, for a thrilling ride from Casablanca to Tangiers at up to 320 km per hour. I'll take you through the sleek train, bustling stations, share trip insights, schedules and prices, and dive deep into Morocco's ambitious high-speed rail project, set to cover 900 km by 2029. Come along! Marhaban, bikum fi dar al-Bayda. Hi and welcome to Casa Voyageurs, the main long-distance train station in Casablanca and Morocco's main railway hub. This beautiful station was unveiled in 2018, replacing the original passenger building dating back to 1923. Inside, there are shops, cafes, and most importantly, one of the few places in the area where decaf coffee is available. Not very popular in Morocco, it can be found here at McDonald's and Starbucks. There's also the Al-BORAQ Lounge, exclusive for first-class passengers in the high-speed Al-BORAQ service I'm using for today's trip to Tangiers. It's comfortable, albeit somewhat basic, with amenities such as water, coffee and a very decent Wi-Fi. I won't stay long because I want to do a little train spotting from a different location. The views from here are okay though, with the clock tower from the original 1923 passengers building as the highlight. From other points on the balcony, I have a better view of the passing trains, and will use this time to begin discussing the renovation of Moroccan train stations. A few weeks ago, we saw the impressive Marrakech station, and today, we are looking at another new building, Casa Voyageurs. This renovation is part of the Moroccan high-speed project, which I will discuss in detail later in the video. For now, it's time to descend to the platform, where ONCF's Alstom Euroduplex Al-BORAQ is parked, awaiting the many passengers traveling on this service to Tangiers. Morocco is undergoing significant economic development, and this high-speed service is a celebration of that progress. I have noticed that many Moroccans I spoke with are very proud of the service and what it means for their country, even if they have never used it. Many, however, do, as can be appreciated by the amount of passengers boarding a midweek 10 a.m. departure. In 2023, over 5 million passengers used this service. In ONCF's configuration, these trains include 2 first-class cars, 5 second-class cars, and 1 cafeteria. They will all show up in one form or another later in the video. It's time to board and head upstairs to my seat. While showing you the first-class interior, the seat, and its amenities, let me tell you a little about this train. The Al-BORAQ is a member of Alstom's Euroduplex family, which is in operation with SNCF in France and with Ouigo in Spain at a maximum speed of 320 km per hour. ONCF bought 12 of these trains, using them on this service from Casablanca to Tangiers. In ONCF's configuration, they are capable of running under both 25 kV alternating current used in the high-speed lines and 3 kV continuous current used in the Moroccan conventional network. The seat is quite comfortable and has all the expected amenities, except for one thing. There's a 220-volt power socket, but no USB ports. From where I see it, in this day and age, USB ports are a basic amenity for any long-distance train. Departure is at 10 a.m. on schedule, being this a good time to discuss prices for this trip. I bought a ticket for 365 Moroccan dirham, 2.5 weeks before departure on ONCF's website. Please note that ticket prices vary depending on how far in advance they are purchased and can be significantly higher or lower. Anyway, the price I paid feels very reasonable for this service. Departing from the original station means also that it's time to check the map for today's trip. From Casa Voyageurs to Tangerville, it's a distance of 313 km, covered in 2 hours and 10 minutes, with stops at Rabat-Agdal and Kenitra. There are two parts to today's trip. The first 127 km from Casablanca to Kenitra, using the conventional line at a maximum speed of 160 km per hour, and the remaining 186 km to Tangiers in the high-speed line at up to 320 km per hour.
Mesdames et messieurs, Al-BORAQ vous souhaite la bienvenue à bord du train grande vitesse numéro 1017 à destination de Tangerville. Nous vous souhaitons un agréable voyage.
Shortly after leaving Casa Voyageurs, I head to the cafeteria for my version of food and scenery. This area provides a pleasant opportunity to enjoy a meal while watching the journey unfold. Next to the tracks, there are several ongoing construction works. This provides a good opportunity to talk about the ambitious Moroccan high-speed project, which aims to create a 900-kilometer network built for speeds of 350 kilometers per hour by 2029. It aims to reduce travel times, as shown in the upper right corner of the screen. After the stop in Rabat, I will continue to provide further information about the project. Choisi minutes after departing Casa Voyageurs, we arrive in Rabat, Morocco's capital, for a brief 3-minute stop. This station, Rabat-Agdal, was modernized to receive this high-speed service, being today as spectacular as Casa Voyageurs. Once again, a sizable number of passengers wait for the train. Moving on, let's discuss the various lines that will make up Morocco's high-speed network by 2029. The first is the high-speed line from Tangiers to Kenitra, which we will enter shortly. It is 186 km long and has been in service since 2018. Travel times were reduced by almost 2 hours and 30 minutes for services using this line. The next is the high-speed line from Kenitra to Casablanca and Marrakech, which will be 431 km long and is currently under construction. Along with the line, new passing stations will be built in Rabat, Casablanca and Marrakech, allowing through services to bypass the existing ones. This will enable ONCF to offer a wider range of services based on commercial needs, some using the existing stations and others the new ones, thus saving time for through services. Finally, there's the high-speed line from Marrakech to Agadir, which is 312 km long and has the same speed parameters as the rest of the network. Construction is also currently underway and the line is expected to be completed by late 2029. All three lines, combined with numerous other upgrades to the current network, will significantly enhance Morocco's railway services and elevate the train to the primary mode of transportation in the kingdom. In no time, we reach Kenitra, an important junction on the Moroccan rail network. This is our final intermediate stop. From here to Tangiers, our train uses the high-speed line, reaching speeds of 320 km per hour and covering the 186 km in just 50 minutes. Like in Rabat, the stop here was brief, and soon we are underway again. Shortly after Kenitra, we split from the conventional track and soon our train cruises at over 300 km per hour. In some sections of the railway, we can catch a glimpse of the nearby Atlantic Ocean. As we arrive at Tangier-Ville, it's time to offer my impressions of the trip. The Al-BORAQ is indeed a motive for pride in Morocco. The train is very good, very clean, with exceptional rolling quality both on conventional and high-speed tracks. It departed and arrived on time, and the service in the stations as on board is very good, professional and attentive. I can only hope to see it extended so that more passengers may benefit from such a nice service. With a final glance at the first class cabin, I bid farewell to the Al-BORAQ, promising to ride it again. For now, I'll walk to the passengers' building, taking you along for a final view of the train's exterior. As I do so and our trip is almost at its end, I want to thank you for coming along on this journey. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, subscribe to my channel and leave me a comment below. Your support is very helpful and, indeed, means a lot. Thank you for being here and see you next week.